So good morning students. Today we are going to discussing about structure of seed. In our previous class we learned development of dicot embryo and monocot embryo. Today we are going to discussing about structure of seed. Listen very careful, Nana. Yes, the two types of seeds. One is dicot seed. Another one is monocot seed. Dicot seed, monocot seed, the two types of seeds are there. You see the dicot seed, this is the dicot seed. Listen very careful. Dicot seed. You know, after fertilization, after post fertilization means post fertilization. Ovary develop into fruit. Ovule develop into seed. After fertilization, ovary develop into fruit. Ovule develop into seed. Yes. Listen. You know, after fertilization, ovule develop into seed. The seed is covered with covered by a seed coat. Which one, sir? Seed coat. After fertilization, ovule develop into seed. The seed is covered by a seed coat. You know, this is a seed coat. This is the which one, sir? Seed coat. This is the seed is covered by a layer, that is a seed coat. Seed coat is the which modification, sir? After fertilization, integuments develop into which one, sir? Seed coat, sir. After fertilization, integuments develop into seed coat. Seed coat is covered with which one, sir? Seed. Seed is covered by a seed coat. Seed is covered by a seed coat. Seed coat is the which one, sir? Yes, after fertilization, integuments develop into seed coat. How many integuments you studied in our previous class? The two integuments. Okay, or if one integument we studied in structure of ovule. For example, you take outer integument and inner integument. What is that, sir? Outer integument is developed into which one, sir? Testa. Inner integument developed into which one, sir? Tegmen. Tegmen. These two are present in a which one, sir? Which one? Seed coat. After fertilization, integuments develop into seed coat. The seed coat has two layers. One is a testa, other one is tegmen. Seed coat has how many layers, sir? Two layers. One layer is a testa, one layer is a tegmen. Testa is the modification of which one, sir? Outer integument. Means after fertilization, outer integument develop into testa, inner integument develop into tegmen. Testa and tegmen both are the two layers. These two layers are present in which one, sir? Seed coat. Seed coat. You see the diagram. This is the seed coat, Nana. This is the seed coat. Seed coat is the word. Integuments are, after fertilization, integuments are developed into seed coat. Within a seed coat, what is there, sir? Testa is there, sir. Tegmen is there, sir. Testa and tegmen. Testa is the outer integument. Tegmen is the inner integument. This is about which one, sir? Seed coat. Seed is covered by a which one? A layer called seed coat. Seed coat. Integuments after fertilization. Integument develop into seed coat. Integument develop into seed coat. How many integuments? Two. Outer integument, inner integument. So outer integument develop into testa. Inner integument develop into tegmen. So testa and tegma, both are the layers present in which one? Seed coat. Seed coat. Right.
This is about which one, sir? Seed coat. Next, coming to other one. What is that, sir? You observe the diagram. This is here, hilum. Hilum. You know, studied in structure of ovule. What is that, sir? Manam ovule structure chedam gurtundo ledo meeku. So, for example, this is an ovule. This is an which one, sir? Ovule. Within a ovule, this is a embryo sac. Okay. Embryo sac. This is which one, sir? Funicule, sir. Funicule. This is a funicule. This is the which one, sir? Body of ovule. This is a body of ovule. What is hilum? This is hilum. Hilum. This is hilum. Hilum means body. This is the total body, sir. Body of ovule attached with funicule. Or funicule attached with the body of ovule. This is the body. This is the funicule. So body and funicule both are attached at a common point. This common point is known as hilum. Hilum. Students, once again, this is the body of ovule. This is the body. This is the funicule. The body and the funicule both are attached at a point. Attached at a point. That point is known as hilum. After fertilization, hilum develop into scare of seed coat. Scare of seed coat. You know seed coat, this is? On the seed coat, what is there, sir? Here this is, you observe, this is a scare. ఒక చిన్న మచ్చలాగా ఉంటుంది చూడండి. దట్ ఈస్ హైలమ్. దట్ ఈస్ హైలమ్. సో యాక్చువల్లీ హైలమ్ మీన్స్ దిస్ ఈస్ ద జంక్షన్. దిస్ ఈస్ ద జంక్షన్ బిట్వీన్ బాడీ ఆఫ్ ఓవ్యూల్ అండ్ ఫినిక్యూల్. బాడీ ఆఫ్ ఓవ్యూల్ అండ్ ఫినిక్యూల్ బోత్ ఆర్ కనెక్ట్ ఎట్ ఎ పాయింట్. దట్ పాయింట్ ఈస్ నోన్ యాజ్ హైలమ్. సో హైలమ్ ఆఫ్టర్ ఫర్టిలైజేషన్ దిస్ హైలమ్ ఈస్ డెవలప్ ఇన్ టు స్కేర్. స్కేర్ ఒక చిన్న మచ్చ. Scare of seed coat. Scare of which one, sir? Seed coat meeda oka chinna machala ga untundi. That is which one, sir? Hilum. What is the function of this hilum, sir? So hilum, through which okay, developing seeds are attached to fruit. Seeds are attached with fruit. Okay, so hilum is the which one, sir? Scare. After fertilization, hilum develop into scare. This is the seed coat. On seed coat, which is there, sir? This is a scare. Oka chinna macha lanti. That is hilum. Em chestundi, sir, idi hilum. Hilum dwara, through which means through hilum, through which developing seeds are attached with which ones, sir? Fruit. Fruit lopala seeds are attukoruntai chusara. Deni dwara attukuntai sir ante hilum. Students, this is the hilum. This is the body of ovule. This is the funicule. Both are attached at a common point called hilum. After fertilization, hilum develop into scare. ఎక్కడది? ఆన్ సీడ్ కోట్. ఆన్ సీడ్ కోట్ ఎందుకు ఉపయోగపడుతుంది? త్రూ విచ్ మీన్స్ త్రూ హైలమ్ ద డెవలపింగ్ సీడ్స్ ఆర్ అటాచ్ విత్ ఫ్రూట్. సీడ్స్ అనేటువంటివి అతుక్కొని ఉంటాయి కదా, దేని ద్వారా అతుక్కొని ఉంటాయి సార్? దట్ ఈస్ అబౌట్ విచ్ వన్? హైలమ్. వాట్ ఈస్ ద నెక్స్ట్ వన్ సార్? మైక్రోపైల్. యు నో స్టడీడ్, దిస్ ఇస్ ద మైక్రోపైల్. This is the which one, sir? Micropyle. What is micropyle, sir? This is the ovule, sir. Ovule covered by integuments. Ovule covered by integuments are protective layers. Ovule అనేది దేని ద్వారా కప్పబడి ఉంది? Integuments. ఏమంటారు సార్ వీటిని? Integuments are protective layers. Total ovule is covered? No. Except the apical region, ovule is covered by the integument. At apical region, a small opening is there. This small opening is known as micropyle. After fertilization, micropyle develop into pore of seed or seed pore. Seed pore. So, for example, you see this one? This is, you observed here. Yes, this is the hylum. This is the which one, sir? Hylum. This is the region. This is the region, which one? Seed pore. This is the which one, sir? This is the hylum. Hylum is the chin of pore. That is seed pore. You observe, sir? This is, for example, seed anko. దాని మీద ఉన్నటువంటి కోట్ మీద ఏముంది సార్ దిస్ ఇస్ ద హైలమ్ అబౌ ద హైలమ్ ఏ పోర్ ఇస్ దేర్ అబౌ ద హైలమ్ ఏ పోర్ ఇస్ దేర్ దట్ పోర్ ఈస్ ఎ సీడ్ పోర్ ఆఫ్టర్ ఫర్టిలైజేషన్ మైక్రోపైల్ డెవలప్ ఇన్ టు సీడ్ పోర్ మైక్రోపైల్ డెవలప్ ఇన్ టు విచ్ వన్ సార్ సీడ్ పోర్ ఆఫ్టర్ ఫర్టిలైజేషన్ మైక్రోపైల్ డెవలప్ ఇన్ టు సీడ్ పోర్ Sir, what is the function of seed pore? Through that pore or seed pore, uptake oxygen and water for the germination of seed. Seed anedi, kinda padesthe mana soil lo lag chesthe germinate avutundi kada, molakettutundi kada. Yes. So, ela sir, through the seed pore, oxygen and water is uptake. Oxygen, water anedi seed pore dwara seed lopaliki velthayi. Okay, right. So, this is about which one, sir? One is hylum, sir. Other one is micropyle. Hylum is the scale on seed coat. Through which developing seeds are attached with fruit. After fertilization, micropyle develop into seed pore. Where the seed pore is present? Yes, above the hylum, a small pore is there. That is known as seed pore. Are you okay, Nana? This is hylum and which one? Seed pore. Next continuation. Listen. Dicot seed. Continuation of dicot seed. Listen very careful. Within the seed. So, seed coat is over. Seed coat containing testa and tegmen. Two layers. Then hylum is over. Then micropyle means seed pore is there. After fertilization, this is developed into seed pore. Micropyle anedi fertilization tarvata deeriga maarutundi seed pore. Seed ki paina oka chinna randram untundi. That is seed pore. Okay, right. Within the seed, this is the dicot seed. Within the seed, which is there, sir? Embryo is there, sir. You already studied, sir. This is embryo. What is that, sir? Dicot embryo. In a dicot embryo, what is there, sir? These two are which is? This one and this one. This is cotyledon. This is which one? Cotyledon. So, dicot seed has which one, sir? Two cotyledons. Already discussed in our previous class. Two cotyledons are what is that, sir? Reserve food. Nana, this is the structure of embryo. Embryo is present in a seed. Seed lopal untundi. Edi sir? Seed lopal untundi embryo sir. Dani gurinche cheptunnanu already cheppanu. Dicot embryo has how many cotyledons? Two cotyledons. This is store the which one? Reserve food. Means the two cotyledons are store the food. Rendu cotyledons food ni store chestayi. They become fleshy. Baga smooth ga maaripothayi rendu kuda. In a dicot embryo, two cotyledons are there. Two cotyledons are store the food, then become fleshy. Food in store chesi, fleshy ga tayar avutayi rendu. Next, you observe, next. In a dicot embryo, two cotyledons is there. Next, coming to, in a dicot embryo, another part is there, that is embryonal axis. What is that, sir? Embryonal axis. You see this one? Yes, this is the embryonal axis. This is the region, which one, sir? Embryonal axis. This is the region, embryonal axis. Below the embryonal axis, this is the hypocotyl. Manam chandram aale. This is the hypocotyl. This is the epicotyl. This is the embryonal axis. In a embryonal axis, the portion below the cotyledon. Ivu rendu cotyledons digunu unnatundi. The portion of embryonal axis below the cotyledons. Ee rendu cotyledons digunundi chudu. Okay, so the portion of embryonal axis below the cotyledons is called hypocotyl. Hypocotyl end with which one, sir? Radical. So in embryonal axis, which is there first one? Hypocotyl. Hypocotyl means the portion of embryonal axis below two cotyledons. What is that, sir? Below two cotyledons. This region is called hypocotyl. Hypocotyl end with which one, sir? End with radical. What is the other one? The portion above the cotyledons. The portion of embryonal axis above the cotyledons. These two cotyledons are fine on 20. This region is epicotyl. Epicotyl is end with which one, sir? Limule. So, another one is epicotyl. Epicotyl end with which one? Plimule. Root is developed from radicle. Shoot is developed from plimule. Hypocotyl end with radicle. Epicotyl end with plimule. Idi hypocotyl region anko. Idi dentho end ayindi? Radicle tho end ayindi. Idi epicotyl region anko. Idi dentho end ayindi? Plimule tho. So, hypocotyl end with which one, sir? Radical. Epicotyl end with plimule. That is. Okay. So, this is the which one? Dicot embryo. Means, in a dicot seed, which is there? Dicot embryo is there. This embryo dent lo undi, sir? This seed lo undi, sir. Within the seed, a dicot seed, this is a. Within the dicot seed, this is the embryo. Embryo has how many parts? Two parts. One is the cotyledon, second one is the embryonal axis. Embryonal any parts are there? Embryonal axis and cotyledons. First one is cotyledon. How many cotyledons? Two cotyledons. One, two. Two cotyledons are stored food. They become fleshy. Other part is embryonal axis. Embryonal axis. Okay, embryonal axis. In embryonal axis, how many parts are there? Two parts. One is hypocotyl, other one is epicotyl. Hypocotyl end with radical. Epicotyl end with plimule. So, hypocotyl end with radical. Epicotyl end with plimule. Okay. This is a structure of which one, sir? Dicot seed. And you observed another one, sir. You know, studied in our previous class also. That is, seeds are here two types. What is that? Endospermic seed, then non-endospermic seed. We already discussed it, sir. Endukante marla seed vachindi kaabatti cheptunna. Within a seed, endosperm is there. That is endospermic seed. What are the examples? You know, studied castor. What is that, sir? Castor and coconut. Say, yes or no? Yes, rice, wheat, you know, rice. This is which one, sir? But this is not a dicot, this is a monocot. So, you know about which one, sir? That is castor. Best example for which one, sir? Endospermic seed. What is that? Castor. And you know, non-endospermic seed without endosperm, seed local endosperm undadu. That is best example of this one is groundnut. Okay, and also pea, then beans. They all are examples of which seeds, sir? Non-endospermic seed. So this is the dicot seed. In a dicot seed, seed coat, hilum, micropyle completed. Within a dicot seed, which is there? Embryo is there. Embryo gurinchi chadam. Then seed. Seed తీసుకుంటే ఏముంది సార్ within a seed endosperm is present, that is endospermic seed. దీని గురించి ఆల్రెడీ ప్రీవియస్ క్లాస్ లో చెప్పాను. నాన్ ఎండోస్పెర్మిక్ సీడ్, సీడ్ వితౌట్ ఎండోస్పెర్మ్ మీన్స్ ఉండదు అంటే ఏమవుతుంది సార్ దట్ ఎండోస్పెర్మ్ ఇస్ టోటలీ కన్స్యూమ్డ్ బై ది ఎంబ్రియో. ఎండోస్పెర్మ్ ఇస్ టోటలీ ఈటెన్ బై ఎంబ్రియో, దట్ ఈస్ నాన్ ఎండోస్పెర్మిక్. ఏ సమ్ అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ ఎండోస్పెర్మ్ ఇస్ ప్రెసెంట్ ఇన్ ఎ సీడ్, లెఫ్ట్ అవుట్ ఇన్ ఎ సీడ్, దట్ ఈస్ ఎండోస్పెర్మిక్ సీడ్. ఎండోస్పెర్మిక్ సీడ్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ క్యాస్టర్, అండ్ నాన్ ఎండోస్పెర్మిక్ సీడ్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ గ్రౌండ్ నట్, పీ అండ్ బీన్స్. Okay, Nana? This is a dicot, structure of dicot seed. Next, coming to other one, monocot seed. Monocot seed. No doubt. This is a monocot seed. You take that, you observe that. In cereals, seeds like maize. దేన్ని తీసుకుంటున్నాను సార్ నేను? Maize, corn. Corn మొక్కజొన్న తెలుసు కదా? Yes. You take this here. In cereals, seed like maize. Structure we will study here. In cereals, seed like maize, what is there? You observe. Listen very carefully. Here which is there, sir? Seed coat. Here you observe seed coat. This is the which one, sir? Seed coat. Seed coat and fruit wall. Seed coat and fruit wall. Fruit wall means pericarp. Pericarp. Fruit wall and pericarp. Both are fuse. Chundana ikkada. ఇక్కడ సీడ్ కోట్ ఫ్రూట్ వాల్ సెపరేట్. ఇక్కడ చూడు, దిస్ ఈస్ ఎ సీడ్ కోట్. దీని మీరు అబ్జర్వ్ చేయండి, యు టేక్ ఎ రైస్, రైస్ కి పైన బ్రౌన్ కలర్ లో ఉంటుంది హస్క్, హస్క్ అంటాము. ఆ హస్క్ ను లోపల గ్రైన్ ఉంటుంది కదా, లోపల గ్రైన్ కు పైన ఉన్నటువంటి ఐ మీన్ కోట్ రెండు కలిసిపోయి ఉంటాయి. సో ద సీడ్ కోట్ అండ్ ఫ్రూట్ వాల్ బోత్ ఆర్ ఫ్యూజ్ ఇన్ విచ్ వన్ సార్? మోనోకాట్ సీడ్ లైక్ యాజ్ విచ్ వన్? Maize. Very important. First point. In monocot seed, seed coat and fruit wall. Fruit wall is nothing but pericarp. The seed coat and fruit wall means pericarp. Both are fused. Rendu kalispoyi attukonuntayi. Paina brown color la husk undi. Lopala chudandi tellaga kanipistu untundi. Rendu kalispoyi untayi anamata. Em em to say? Seed coat and fruit wall. Fruit wall is nothing but pericarp. Both are fused. Rendu kalispoyayi antunna. Right. Next. You observed very interesting one here, sir. This is a monocot seed. It containing, this is endosperm. This is which one, sir? Endosperm. This is which one, sir? Embryo. This is embryo. The monocot seed, within this seed containing which one? This is endosperm, this is embryo. This is more endosperm, this is embryo. Listen very carefully. Endosperm is sticky. Endosperm is sticky. For example, you take a rice. Rice boiled chesina tarvata ela untundi nana? It is a sticky, attukuntundi kada. Yes, that is endosperm. Endosperm is sticky and store which one, sir? Store food. Endosperm tissue is stored by which one? Food. Yes, listen. Very good. This is endosperm. Endosperm is which one? Sticky and store food. Next, very interesting one. Outer layer of endosperm is separated embryo. Embryo and endosperm both are separated. The outer layer of endosperm is separate embryo from endosperm. You observe here. This layer is called as aleuron layer. Which layer, sir? eluron layer. Students, this is endosperm, this is embryo. Endosperm and embryo, both are separated by a layer. Both are separated by a layer. Yes, this is the, both are separated by a layer. Yes, this layer is called as, which one sir? Eluron layer. So, note it. Outer layer of endosperm or layer of endosperm separate embryo called which layer sir? Eluron layer. Nana idi endosperm idi embryo kada ee endosperm embryo rendu separate avutu unnatundi layer. Yes, a layer separate the embryo from endosperm is called which one? Eluron layer is store the proteins. Ee eluron layer lo em untai sir? Proteins untai nana manam polish chesam anku rice ni ekkuva white ga. If you polish the rice, more polish the rice, this eluron layer is removed. Eluron layer is removed means proteins are removed. Nowadays, we will eat only a starch. We will eat only a endosperm. Not a eluron layer. Eluron layer is removed because it is more polished. So that if more polished grains, that remove the which one? Eluron layer. Actual function of eluron layer? That eluron layer is a protein, store the proteins. That's why this is a proteinaceous layer. Eluron layer is also called as which one sir? Proteinaceous layer. Proteins in store chasani kabatti dani proteinaceous layer. Mari ikkada chudna. This is a layer. A layer separate. What is that sir? A layer separate. Which one? Layer of endosperm separate embryo. Embryo ni endosperm nunchi separate chestunnatvanti ee layer ni em antunnan sir? Eluron layer. What is the function of eluron layer? Eluron layer store the proteins. That's why this layer is called as proteinaceous layer. Okay, right. Next coming to other one, you observe that is, what is that sir? Here you observe this is endosperm, this is embryo. You observe the embryo. In a monocot embryo, how many cotyledons are there? Only one cotyledon. Yesterday I told this is development of monocot embryo. You observe sir, this is an area. This area is called as which one sir? Scutellum. Yesterday I told, in grass family, one cotyledon is there. That is called scutellum. So, in monocot embryo, what is that sir? Single cotyledon. That is a shield shaped cotyledon. You observe? Yes, this is the region. Here, this is a shield shaped, this region. The shield shaped cotyledon is called, which one sir? Scutellum. Nana embryo gurinchi cheptunnanu intaku mundu dicot lo embryo gurinchi cheppalam. Same in monocot seed, this is the structure of embryo. We already studied, but once again repeat it here. In embryo, this is total portion is embryo. Idu mottham embryo. In embryo, here which is there sir? A shield shaped structure. Here idu ee space mottham, a shield shaped structure is known as scutellum. This is present only in grass family, Poaceae family. That is rice, wheat, maize, sorghum. They all are grasses. Belongs to the family, grass family or Poaceae family. So in grass family or Poaceae family, what is that? Shield shaped cotyledon. How many cotyledons? Only one cotyledon. Because monocot embryo, only one cotyledon is present. This is called scutellum. scutellum. Okay, right. Next, you observed other one, sir. This is embryonal axis. This is which one? Embryonal axis. Embryonal axis. This is embryonal axis. In embryonal axis, the portion below the cotyledons is called which one, sir? Here. This is here, which is hypocotyl. So hypocotyl end with which one? Radicle. What is that, sir? Hypocotyl. Hypocotyl end with which one, sir? Embryonal axis having hypocotyl and epicotyl. So hypocotyl end with which one? Radicle. Hypocotyl end with radicle. Listen very careful. This is embryo. Within embryo, a single shield shaped structure is known as scutellum. Next, coming to this is the embryonal axis. In embryonal axis, below the the hypocotyl end with radicle. Very interesting one here, students. Radicle is protected by a sheath that is coleoriza. ఈ radicle ని ప్రొటెక్ట్ చేస్తూ ఉండే షీత్ ఏది సార్ దిస్ ఇస్ కోలియోరైజర్ సో రాడికల్ ఇస్ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ బై ఏ షీత్ ఆ షీత్ ఏమంటున్నాను నేను దట్ షీత్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ కోలియోరైజర్ నానా ఎంబ్రియో గురించి కదా మనం మాట్లాడుతుంది ఇక్కడ దిస్ ఇస్ ఎంబ్రియోనల్ యాక్సిస్ ఈ ఎంబ్రియోనల్ యాక్సిస్ లో రాడికల్ ఉంది ప్లిమ్యూల్ దిస్ ఇస్ ద ప్లిమ్యూల్ అది చెప్తాను దిస్ ఇస్ రాడికల్ రాడికల్ కవర్డ్ బై ఏ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ బై ఏ షీత్ దట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ కోలియోరైజా సో ఇన్ ఎంబ్రియోనల్ యాక్సిస్ హియర్ హియర్ లోయర్ సైడ్ విచ్ ఇస్ ప్రెసెంట్ రాడికల్ ఇస్ ప్రెసెంట్ రాడికల్ ఈస్ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్ బై ఏ షీత్ ఏ లేయర్ కాల్డ్ కోలియోరైజా సిమిలర్లీ విచ్ వన్ సార్ Plimule, sir. In a embryonal axis, below the embryonal axis, lower end which is radicle. Radicle is protected by coleoriza. In embryonal axis, above the region which is there, this is a plimule. This is the which one, sir? Plimule. This is a plimule. This is a which one, sir? Sorry. This is a which one? Plimule. Plimule is protected by a sheath. Plimule is protected by a sheath. Okay, plimule is protected by a sheath. Students, listen very careful here. This is plimule. This is coleoptile. So plimule in your embryonal axis above the portion is called hypocotyl. Sorry, epicotyl. It is end with plimule.